Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Let's Play. Hearts of Iron 4, Red Flood is Russia. Let us continue on from we last left off. So we have finally actually unified Russia. We've taken over the Far East. We've taken over Central Asia. Everything is looking pretty good. I mean, the world's kind of falling apart. Austria's at war with the Germans, and that's fine. Okay, if they want to fight each other, let them fight each other. It allows us to kind of recuperate our position here. Now, I believe all of our men are where they need to be. I'm actually going to switch you guys out because you do need unique colors so I can actually tell you apart. You guys can be the blue army. Excellent. So green, we're going to push you to the border Poland like so. And then for like this turquoise here, I guess you're going to just take Vilnius, I think seems fine. I don't know what else we really need you to do. But once we're done with Made in Russia, we're then going to immediately go into War for Holy and Triune Russia, which is going to give us a lovely cost of belly. We're going to just—I mean, actually, just to give us a cost of belly. We just straight up declare war on the Polish, and then after that, we do have some choices here. This is an alliance with Sweden. Okay, you are. I don't know. Austria is not going to exist very soon. So I think our only choice is going to be to join up with the Swedish. For some reason, Portugal joins as well. I'm not too sure what they're up to. I don't know why they're joining, but that's fine. And then we declare war on Germany, and we declare war on France. And that's going to kind of be the campaign right there and there. I want to modify our garment anyway. Heavy equipment. You know what? What do we want here? Do we have anything for, like, tanks? 10% cheaper trucks. Do we have anything for cheaper tanks? 10% cheaper medium tanks. Let's just go with, like, an artillery upgrade. I think seems fine. Deploy what aircrafts we actually have in storage. What even are you guys? Okay. Let's have you on purple. We're going to put some of you on blue, and then the rest of you we're going to put on green army. You're kind of hot garbage, I will admit, which I'm not, you know, obviously I'm not a fan of that. But what can I do? Take the 41 artillery upgrade. That's what I can do. Now, I am feeling pretty confident. Maybe I'm feeling overly confident with an invasion of Poland. But I believe in us. I believe in our ability to destroy Ukraine, take Belarus, take over Estonia and Lithuania. I think we're going to be looking quite good. We'll take a 40. We have so many research slots. You know, we have so many research slots. I actually feel pretty comfortable. One, we have not taken 1938 research. That is my bad. I said I feel pretty confident going with the nuclear upgrades. No, I do not. Not if I don't even have the 38 research. Okay, but I think it's time. Actually, we're going to wait for this to fill up for... Oh, we actually have 15 days. Okay. We're going to wait for this to fill up for 15 days. Just to give Poland the least amount of time to actually actively prepare for a conflict. It'll give us our best chance. Because they only have like 6 days to deploy against us. As opposed to a full 21. Which is good. It's good for us. Aside from that, I would like just more... planes, please. And we need... Actually, no. We're negative 2, negative 1. That's actually fine. That's actually not bad at all. I will have all of our units ready for an invasion. What do we have for you? Do we have infantry expert? No. Organize, reinforce plus 2%. You know what? Actually, give me supply consumption. We're going to have, like, very, very large armies. So I think reducing the amount of supplies we're using would be nice. And you know what, actually... Deploy these tanks. Again, reinforcements are top priority. Let's throw you in here. I do have too many tanks. Do I even have, like, another field marshal? Actually, I probably should put all the tanks in one army, huh? Like, that's usually how you play this. You know, actually, give me all of my tank divisions. Throw them all underneath this commander. The tank division could be the white army. We're going to have you... I'm trying to think, like, where I want you to drive through. Because it's all river. So I guess just, like, right here to blitz your way straight into Vilnius and maybe even take, to push your way towards Brest as well. Or cavalry... You know, I will deploy these trucks. This seems okay. You know, actually deploy these cavalry divisions as well. And these cavalry, which I thought I just deployed. Maybe I actually didn't. No, I pressed the wrong button. Deploy these cavalry, please. This seems okay. We're going to be down, like... I'm still down, like, a few units, but it's not that bad. Get our tanks where they need to be, please and thank you. Okay. So this is Second War of the Wilkenkrieg? Excellent. Okay. So there goes our invasion here. Aside from that, what do we want? We've already taken our army bonuses. I guess we'll go with our transporter flights next. And I think everybody just kind of goes for it. Estonia, I'm pretty sure, will just collapse like immediately. I'm not too worried about their position. We've embargoed by Sweden, but I think we'll probably join up with the Swedish anyway very, very soon. And let's push away towards Vilnius. Get our tanks in position here. Push away straight across. I'm not going to worry about the other fronts. I just want to see these areas collapse sooner rather than later. Infantry, let's move you over to here. Let's see if we actually get you straight to the border of Prussia. Because I think Prussia's in the Swedish faction, right? They are. And everybody is embargoing me, which is, I would say, one, a little rude. Two, how is Estonia not dead? I do not know, but you guys are just going to bomb Poland, please. How is Estonia not dead? They collapsed at 20%. What cities have we not taken? I mean, I guess there's a few here, but... There we go. I was wondering, like, how the hell are you not dead? There are some Polish divisions around here, but I'm not, like, too worried about that. Tank divisions. We're going to pull you down here. And you know what? Can I have you just, like, blitz your way straight into Warsaw? Because that I would feel very, very happy about. I will say the push into Ukraine and Belarus are not going, like, super, super well. I mean, I say that. You guys can move your way to Brest, right? Like this? I believe in you. I believe in you. This is going to get completely wiped out. Let's see if we can make you go down towards Lvov. Way in the south. And I guess we'll just go air... I mean, air research time goes up. Or I guess goes down, technically, depending on how you want to look at things. All of that, to me, sounds lovely. Keep pulling you down. Take Lvov. Get your way to the border of Romania. Kind of cut the Commonwealth in half. And you guys now, your job is to spearhead your way, I guess, like, towards Krakow. To me, that just kind of seems like the best plan. I don't even know if you guys actually have battle plans anymore. So you're going to go in this direction. You guys are also just going to kind of go this way as well. I mean, I do have everybody on extremely aggressive maneuvers, and that's fine. How close is anybody else to capitulation? Ukraine's not close. Belarus is getting there. We can maybe kind of push in from behind. I will say, Red Army, you've kind of let me down a little bit. But that's okay. Everybody lets me down every once in a while. Okay, tanks, if you can approach where you need to be, get your way over towards Poznan in the north. Now, we didn't take Lvov. Not right away, at least. And actually, you've gotten yourself encircled. I mean, if you can take the city and just kind of hang out, I'll be happy. And for you, I do really want you to take Kiev. We're not building any tanks. That's okay. No, not any tanks. We're not building any aircraft, which is fine for now. Is it because the Dutch don't like me? Yes. Italy, thing is, I do really like this flag. It's a little bit funky. Norway. Thing is, nobody actually likes us. Which is kind of a problem. Because we're going to be going to war with Germany. We're going to be going to war with France as well very, very soon. So it does put us in a very, very weird spot. We've embargoed by Bolivia. I don't care. Let's get this tank to go down like this. Move these tanks, move this truck over. You're still doing a fine job. You did take Minsk. So presumably Belarus, 21%. So if we can take like this city, Belarus should fall. You know, speak of the devil. And we should take Warsaw in just a second as well. Like Poland is basically donezo. Battlefield support for sure. The United States embargoed us. Look, we'll worry about the embargoes afterwards. Right now, I'm not super concerned. Yeah, drive you out like this. Capitulation of Poland is at... I mean, next capitulate, 15, which is pretty low. Considering where they normally are at. Okay, so I think a lot of our armies here don't really actually need to be pushing anymore. They can kind of stay on these fronts. Actually, except for Red. Red actually needs to spread out something like this. Okay, we did take Lvov. We do need more supplies. There's no denying that. We need more building materials. We've been embargoed by small, tiny Indian kingdoms now. How much are you worth? 5? Strategic bombers, air superiority, or ace generation. I guess we'll go with balanced approach. Air superiority is always nice. Let's see if we can take Krakow. Oh, okay. The fall of the free city. The reason failure is the intermedium in a war against the aggressor. Prussia will not simply wait for the Poles to recover this morning. Prussia units enter the free Hanseatic city of Danzig. Okay. That's fine. I'm not going to worry about that too much. Excuse me. Let us integrate these territories. We could just join the Entente. We could organize... Okay, so what can we do? Right? If we make them a... thing is, like... If we're in a faction, does this, like, bypass... Because again, we could just join up with the British. Britain has the Dutch. They got a pretty large empire. There's no denying that. Integrate Poland. We cannot do that. We can integrate Ukraine and Belarus. So I see no reason not to do so. And for our new armies... Go to one army here. Go one army here. One army here. Green we're going to put here. The tank divisions we're going to put on the north side. And red army we're going to bring down here as well. Everybody is basically going to go with the border of the Germans. And I think I have to organize. I can't integrate them. So we do need to organize Poland in 14 days. This will allow us to join up, I guess, with, like, again, it's with Sweden. Which is a bit of a weird alliance, for sure. Does it bypass if we're in an alliance? We'll cancel if not met. I mean, we can also only do these if they're a subject of ours. So we have to do this in order to even advance to our thing here. Give me close to air support, please. And how long until you're done? 6 days, huh? Things, I don't think I need to join the Entente. I mean, it would make the Entente very powerful. I don't think there's anybody denying that. But, like, Britain, what do you actually have? Really a navy, right? And our ability to invade via the Netherlands. But I don't think I care about that too much. At peace is not in a faction. Waterfall must be true. Prussia and Austria don't exist. Which won't happen. Can't do you. Yes, I'm pretty sure the only thing we can do is join up with the Swedish. A new hope. Okay, so this is for Poland. Our crusade turns to its conclusion. Remains of the old Santos regime stand shattered at the signs of our marching feet in Warsaw, Minsk, Kiev. The threat of the Intermediarium stands vanquished, but an age-old question remains. Quo vadis? Or rather, where should the Polish nation go on from here? It will be Poland of might and justice, a self-governing kingdom in a union with a glorious empire, as it always has been. Spindians, lunatics might have taken a vision of a truly national Poland through their machinations, but nothing is beyond repair. Soon a new Poland will rise in the ashes of what they have destroyed, stronger than ever before, but who shall lead it? On the forefront, Preszki is a young man with new ideas, a voice which many hope will inspire a modern generation of Poles to take our side. Taking on the teaching of the union of young Russia on his own, he's got a mix of industrialism and radical nationalism, though popular with Poles and exiles, many worry about his unconventional ideas, thinning the line between nationalism in Warsaw and that of Lee Soel. Despotic party, reactionary party. We'll probably want to go with you, right? Because it's the same ideology. Okay, we got a new guard. Approach me, will fulfill promises made years prior. Or we go with the more orthodox choice. Let's go. Why not go with the reactionaries here? Why not? We got our new kingdom of Poland. Fantastic. They're a lovely puppet of ours. The borders are a little finicky, I will admit. And then I think we want green army here. And we'll keep red army here. I think this seems very reasonable. Okay. One general offense that can move their way into Germany. We got our tanks up here. The tanks actually need to be realigned. But the tanks are going to be in a good position. And I do want to join. The only thing we can do is renew our alliance with Sweden. For some reason, Portugal also joins. I don't know why, but I guess we'll take them. I see no reason not to. And then after that, we're just going to invade Germany. I don't know how many units does Germany have. Honestly, like, not a lot. And they're still in a war with Austria as well, so they're going to be kind of fighting a two-front war. Which I think gives us a good position to fight them. So Sweden, what's your ideology? You're conservative, you are polyarchy. And polyarchy is still aligned with us. So I'm still happy to work with them. And now, we are an alliance. Oh, actually, I just take over being the leader of the alliance. Oh, well, that's very nice. Thank you very much, Sweden, for allowing me to completely take over everything that's happening here. And again, we're going to do the same thing we did before, which is just waiting their 15 days. Okay, Russia has joined up with the Birkenland. After restoring order across the wide reach of Russia and finally ending the struggle with the rival government Harbin, the reborn empire has embarked on resuming its place in international politics. The Russian unification has already sent Poland and his allies into a frenzy, as the Russian invader sets his right on recovering the territories it lost in the wake of the Civil War. With tensions already rising and the possible war growing each day, the Emperor has moved towards aligning itself with the Birkenland alliance. Already a close ally of Prussia before the summer coup of 36, Russia and Birkenland's alignment comes out as a common stance, and the chaos that brought Europe to the mad zones of modernity, France and Germany. So we could theoretically send troops to the border of Denmark. Because remember, Denmark and Norway are going to get involved in this war as well. But I'm feeling pretty confident. Red Army, we're going to have you move towards Budapest. Green Army, we're going to send you into... you're going to go into Transylvania. And then Red Army, I just want you to be on half the border, okay? I don't need you everywhere. And how many troops do you actually have? Basically zero, as far as I'm concerned. So the invasion should go very, very well for us. Just build military factories or wherever, man. It doesn't matter. We're golden. We could return Prussian territory. Which is what? Pomerelia and Posen. Which is you. These two provinces here. I'm going to say no. Yeah, I see no reason to join up with the Entente, okay? I'm actually, you know what? I could just give them territory. But, I mean, why would I take territory away from my own puppet state to give it to the Prussians? They can have territory over here in Germany when the time comes. But I will say that at least right now, this would be a good time for us to end this episode. So if you enjoyed it, thumbs up. Not enjoying it, please thumbs down. You want to see more, subscribe, and goodbye.